product of a fraction times a mixed number and the product of two mixed numbers will be illustrated with fraction bars in this video. We will also illustrate the reciprocal of a fraction, something that will be very important in the upcoming videos on division. If 1 1/4 gallons of paint, now let that be 1 full gallon, that's a fourth of a gallon, are used to paint 3 walls of the same size, how much paint is used for each wall? So now we're going to spread this amount of paint, 1 1/4 gallons, equally over 3 walls. So each wall is going to be require 1/3 of this amount of paint. So I want 1/3 of 1 1/4. We can divide this whole gallon of paint roughly into 3 parts. And we'll take one of those. So 1/3 of a whole is 1/3. Then we want to take 1/3 of 1/4. 1/3 of 1/4. We know that's 1/3 times 1/4, which is 1/12. So we want to combine. So 1/3 plus 1/12. 1/3 now going to be 4/12 plus 1/12 equals 5/12. So 1/3 of 1 1/4 is 5/12 gallons. Now to look at this example in terms of multiplication, we know that of can be replaced by times. So we have 1/3 times 1 1/4, and is 1/3. 1 1/4 can be written as 1 plus 1/4, and now we can multiply the 1 by 1/3 and the 1/4 by 1/3. This is a distributive property. Distributive property of multiplication over addition. So we saw in the illustration, we took 1/3 of a whole bar and then 1/3 of 1/4. So we multiply into those, we get 1/3 plus 1/12. And then replace this by 4/12 plus 1/12 equals 5/12. So in this illustration above here, we illustrated taking 1/3 of a whole and taking 1/3 of a fourth. And we also illustrated the distributive property. They would multiply each one of these separately and then add the two amounts. So to multiply a fraction times a mixed number, we multiply with the fraction times the whole number part and then the fraction times the fraction part and add the two. For another example, if it takes 1 1/3 gallons of paint, let this be 1 gallon, 1/3 of a gallon, to cover 1 wall, and 2 1/2 walls that would be painted, how much paint is needed? So we're going to use this much paint 2 1/2 times. So we've got 2 1/2 times 1 1/3. Now let's first take this amount of paint 2 times. So 2 times 1 1/3. 2 times 1 is 2, plus 2 times 1/3 is 2/3. So this is 2 2/3. And then we'll take 1/2 times this amount of paint. So 1/2 times 1 1/3 is going to be 1/2 times 1. That's going to be 1/2. And 1/2 times 1/3 is going to be 1/6. And this is 2/3. So now we got these two amounts. This is going to equal 2 2/3. Plus 2/3, and that's 4/3, and 2, that's going to be 3 1/3. So 3 1/3 gallons of paint will be needed. To find the total amount of paint for 2 1/2 walls, we use two products, 2 times 1 1/3 and 1/2 times 1 1/3. Now these two partial products can be avoided by using improper fractions. 2 1/2 times 1 1/3. We'll replace each of these mixed numbers by improper fractions. That's going to be 5 over 2 times, this is going to be 4 over 3. That's going to be 20 over 6. And the 6 parts in a whole bar, so we're going to have 3 whole bars and 2 6, or 3 and 1 3rd. So another method of multiplying mixed numbers is to convert the mixed numbers into improper fractions and then multiply numerator by numerator and denominator by denominator. Suppose you have 1 1/2 of something. You will let that be represented by a whole bar and a half a bar. And you wish to take 2/3 of it. Here we have 1 1/2, 1 1/2. Also can be represented as 3/2. And we want 2/3 of 1 1/2, or 3/2. Now we can use a rule for multiplying of, we can replace by times. So this is a multiplication example. 2 times 3 is 6. 3 times 2 is 6. This is equal to 1. So 2/3 of 3/2 is 1. Now we can also think about the meaning of the fraction 2/3. This means divide something into 3 equal parts. So let's divide this. This is divided already into half. Divide this in half. So we have 1, 2, 3/2. And the 2 tells us to take 2 of those. Well, 2 of those 3/2 is just 2/2 is 1. So you can see visually that 2/3 of 3/2 is going to be 1. And we can see by the multiplying the fractions that the result is also 1. Two numbers whose product is 1 are called reciprocals of each other. 2/3 is a reciprocal of 3/2, and 3/2 is a reciprocal of 2/3. The reciprocal of any fraction, if it is not 0, can be found by interchanging the numerator and denominator. Here the 2 and the 3 were interchanged and became the 3 and the 2, and we know these are reciprocals of each other. So the reciprocal of 3/5 is going to be 5 over 3, because the product of these is 1. The reciprocal of 5 is 1 over 5, because the product here is 5 over 5, which is 1. Here are two products from the 4th test given by the National Assessment of Educational Progress. Let's model the first product, 4 times 2 and a 4th, by using 2 whole bars and a 1/4 bar. The 2 whole bars taken 4 times can give us a total of 8, and 4 of the 1/4 bars is 1 whole bar, so the total is 9. 30% of the 11th graders did not get the correct answer of 9. The second product, 4 times 1/5, means 4 of the 1/5. Approximately 1/4 of the 11th graders did not get the correct answer of 4/5. The ideas in the two examples we have just seen are not difficult. In both examples, we are taking 4 of something. For some students, the symbols and operations do not make sense. Let's play 2-par golf on fractionbars.com. Be careful of the sand traps and the water hazards.
This round of golf will include a twosome, and their names are Kim and Lee. We click tee off, and Kim clicks the ball on tee number 1. Kim has to enter the correct answer in order to par the hole. Nice shot. Kim parred the hole. Next, Lee will tee off. Lee missed his second shot, so now he's going to try his third shot. Lee topped the ball. This was a tough hole for Lee. There are lots of sand traps and water hazards on this 9-hole course.